playing their style, but Fahey made up his own tunes, recorded his own songs. He had Americana titles like Last Steam Engine Train, The Catfish Is in Bloom. These things appeal to me. The titles alone appeal to me. But anyway. Tidy work you did over here, Carol.
And you too, sir.
I'm surprised that the packages didn't go all over the place. Yeah, you did good. You've done good. All right. I'm sorry that I didn't bring any of my CDs today, but I didn't. So what are you gonna do about it? You know? There's nothing you can do about it. All right. At any rate, my habits are killing me.
Yeah.
That's what you're going to hear. And it's, it kind of bothers me that a lot of my friends relate to this. But all right, here it is. My habits are killing me. This is from Notes from Suburbia, which is a lovely cover photo of my old lawnmower outside my house. And I had, it died about 5 years after this was put out. We had a funeral service at the recycling center for it. I was the only one there. Ah, here you go. My habits are killing me, it's time to change. The nasty things I do to myself, things I've learned to hate, managed to habituate. My habits are killing me, it's time to change. Don't like it here, stuck in the mud. Good people and friends get taken down. Don't like hospitals or their pills. Habits don't kill you, their food surely will. I eat organic produce every week, and once in a while, free range meat. But I got a nasty passion for whiskey and beer. My poor liver is living in fear. My habits are killing me, it's time to change. Nasty things I do to myself. Amount of caffeine I drink, bad for my spleen. I think my habits are killing me, it's time to change. Got a nasty penchant for imported beers. My poor liver is living in fear. My habits are killing me, it's time to change. Nasty things I do to myself. Meat I drink is bad for my spleen, I think. Habits are killing me, it's time to change.
Beyond your means, beyond your means.
says to find is not what it seems, and you live beyond your means. Your chest, create a big block, list up your mental health. While prestige is less of an issue, when you're secure within yourself, beyond your means, beyond your means. Your life becomes a nightmare, not a pretty dream, when you live beyond your means, beyond your means. Here's one from instrumental solo guitar. Thank you. Let's go to a song that has not found its way onto a recording yet. It's called What It Feels Like. And I've done this on nylon string before, but that Linda suggestion, that, and it being a good one, try it on the steel string, and I think I favor it like this. Thank you, Lynn. I'm not sure. I think there's might be two videos floating around out there. One from Coyote Ridge of this song. I did a loop. Renaissance Lute and Guitar show at Coyote Ridge about 4 or 5 years ago, and that was, I think, the first time I played it out. Then maybe last year's Lyceum Theater Masters of the Guitars, I think. I'm not sure if I played it on steel string there. I definitely favor it on a steel string, I believe, Lynn. Same tuning as Water Song. Thank you. That would work very well on 12 string. That's quite right. Yeah. What's that?
Did Harlan Nocturne make the list?
No, it didn't. Sorry, bro. I have videos of that out on YouTube, so we've done that. We've done it here too, right? Yeah, we've done it. Right. That's a good one though. I used to do with Larry Amato, and now I do it with John Grunberg, Gus. People know him as Gus. Gus Cannon. Larry and I used to do this song a lot, I think down in the basement where the whiskey and the weed was. It's called the Archives now. That's where the Ragtime Millionaire's Follies happen almost every Wednesday. We make up banjo songs in the basement and in the driveway. Right. Kids come home from school, they see two old men playing in their driveway. They go, now they don't pay attention really, because they're walking down the street and they're looking at their phone. I'm waiting for somebody to have a manhole cover open or something. Not that I want it to happen, but it could happen. Mississippi John, all right. Larry, correct me if I'm wrong, but we probably played this at his gravesite together. Yeah. Can't be satisfied. Get that train and ride. Yeah, we were gonna do that one together, but it didn't work out, so what the hell.
It's a good thing, it's a 40 senior playing, I don't play like this.
Yeah, I know, I mean, but it's 12 bars. All right, let's do a little open D tuning, open dad gad rather, D-A-D, G-A-D.
Yeah.
It would be nothing for us to do a bunch of those songs, Larry, honestly, really. I mean, we've done it before, and it would take minutes to get together. We could have done it tonight. No problem. We got plenty of music. A fellow named Davy Graham is credited with inventing this tuning to keep up with Moroccan oud players. And I'm not sure it's a fact, but it's a myth that could be a fact. Bert Jansch, the British guitarist, was very fond of this tuning. This tune that I'm going to do now used to be called the Dave Bernroth Suggestion. Yeah, pitiful title, I know. But it was a student of mine that said, why don't you write something in Dagad? So I called it the Dave Bernroth Suggestion. And then when I completed, I said, nah. Because there's certain intervals and riffs that reminded me programmatically of going out to Lancaster, PA for a gig and getting behind the Amish horse-drawn carriages, you know, so. So that's why it's called Buggy Ride now.